This will be the Logitech G hub for the MX518. When you first start it up, you see your mouse located here. You click on your mouse, and that brings us into the first area, which is our commands or our controls. You can see each button is indicated on the side here, letting you know what is what. You have the option of default, which left click, right click, or you can G shift, which will pretty much wipe out everything, and you can assign from scratch. And that is under our commands. Should we need to, you have your editing tools, which we can assign to any one of our buttons. Likewise, you have Windows keys and etc. We're going to come across to keys, and then we can search for specific commands if we wanted to assign them to one of these options. Likewise, we have actions, which allows us quite nicely to have access to Overwolf, Discord, and OBS. You can also set up macros from here simply by searching for a macro that you've already created, or we can create a new macro. You also have system, which will allow you to assign system level keys to a particular key. We're going to come all the way back up to command, and we're going to select, hypothetically, the forward key. Right now it's set at use default, but we can disable and reassign a different action to it if we wanted to. I'm simply going to click off of that because I'd like to keep that in place. Now, that was our assignments. Normally, when you first log in, you're going to be on your sensitivity. This is where you can assign your shifting DPI setting all the way down to 400 up to 3200. And here you can see we can even go past that because 3200 is the maximum that I have currently set, but we can shift this all the way up. And you'll notice that the yellow icon here is indicating your shift speed, so the shift between the three presets that I have. Coming down, you have assigned these to your mouse, or we can change the report rate per second. Right now it's on 1000, I can lower it all the way down to 125. You can also use this area to restore the default. And for the MX518, this is really all you can do with the G Hub software. Now, if you wanted to switch over to the onboard memory for your MX518, you simply come up to the settings wheel in the upper right-hand corner, and then notice it says onboard memory off. We would select on, and that will change it from the G Hub software to the onboard memory. When you open your onboard memory for your MX518, you will see the mouse indicated right here, and then profile 1 through 5. So you can set up individual profiles on the mouse itself to take with you if you're using a computer that does not utilize G Hub already pre-installed. Here you can see the DPI, 400 all the way up to 6400. I have it capped, you can see right there, at 3200. Your report rate, again, from 125 all the way up to 1000, I have it up to 1000. And then here we can assign our mouse buttons. Just like before, with the default, your primary button 1 and 2 cannot be changed. However, if we change it to G Shift, all of our buttons on our mouse become accessible to change as we wish. If we wanted to change middle button 3, we simply come over and select what we would like it to do. And that works with any of them. If we wanted to identify a button, we simply click on identify and then press. And here you'll see that it lets us know what button it was that we were selecting. And really, that's all we can do with the onboard memory for the MX518.